Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, in this modern world, the world is searching for role models. Everyone is looking at and searching for role models. Since they do not have a proper role model or in their life, they imitate the so-called worldly models, some celebrities, cricket stars, football stars, movie stars, and many other people. And whatever they do, our young children are trying to imitate. Their dress code they imitate, the hairstyle they imitate, the body decorations that they do on their body they imitate. Even some people put tattoos and they imitate. And I've seen many young boys and girls putting tattoos in the whole body because someone whom they adore also has got tattoos. I remember one of our team members when the Divinity Center, some of you may know the singers there, Glenn and Teresa. Glenn was in the 13 AD band some years ago and he used to have all body tattoos. But later when he got converted, he removed all the tattoos. And I asked him, what kind of tattoo? How did you remove it? And then he said, Father, those days in order to just to attract boys and youngsters, we used to have duplicate tattoos. It's not original. It's only some sticky ones and it can be removed after some time. And this is how many so-called models are trying to attract people. And when Glenn got converted, totally changed, he publicly confessed it and said, this is how we used to attract people. And now he's attracting the children of God and God and attracting people to God. My dear brothers and sisters, remember this. When you imitate all these people who are into the world, who promote evil, I'm not talking about every celebrity, but there are so many so-called people, worldly, secular, certain celebrities who promote abortions, promote all kinds of evil tendencies and all kinds of bad habits, hatred, revenge, and all kinds of ruthlessness. There are so many youngsters who imitate them, even Christian, Catholic, and everyone imitate them. Their dress code, behavior, attitude, language, everything. This is something that we have to be very, very careful. Let's see what God says about this. We read Proverbs chapter 3 verse 31 onwards. Proverbs chapter 3 verse 31 onwards. Do not envy the violent and do not choose any of their ways. Do not envy the violent and do not choose any of their ways. Don't ever choose any of their ways who are promoting violence, evil, abominations, perverseness. Do not even imitate them. Do not even copy them. Do not even follow them. Do not even have any connection with them. For the perverse are an abomination to the Lord, but the upright are in his confidence. The perverse generations, perverse activities, the people who are doing perverse activities, and they are abomination to the Lord. Maybe in front of the public, they may get lots of fame and name and media attention and so many followers and subscribers, but in front of God, they are abomination. Therefore, do not even imitate them. Do not even take any of their ways. Verse 33. The Lord's curse is on the house of the wicked, but he blesses the abode of the righteous. The curse of God will be there on them. And also we read this word of God, Proverbs chapter 4 verse 14 and 15. Chapter 4 verse 14 and 15. Do not enter the path of the wicked. Do not walk in the way of evildoers. All the evildoers, whatever they take, do not take their way. Don't walk in the way of the evildoers. Avoid it. Do not go on it. Avoid it. turn away from it and pass on. Avoid it, do not go on it, turn away from it. Very strictly, three times. Avoid it, do not go on it, turn away from it and pass on. Do not enter the path of the wicked. Anyone who promote wickedness, evil, violence, there are some people, if you walk around, you can see even some car and vehicles, they have stickers of horrible symbols of Satan, symbols of all horrible things, skulls and all those things. And many youngsters are getting attracted to these. We don't know why they are attracted to these horrible videos, horrible pictures. Even some small children are wearing the t-shirts in which there is horrible pictures. It is very dangerous. It is not good. We have so many, you know, unknowingly and knowingly, these small children's mind will be turned towards the negativities. They will always, slowly, they will always want to do something evil, some drinks and some alcohol, some drugs. They will have a tendency, even when they sit in front of the Blessed Sacrament, they feel like falling into sin because they are carrying these symbols in their body. They carry such kinds of things in their mind. I have seen many people, some people, they always want to do good. Some people, they always want to do evil. Now they are doing, both of them are very good because they are in a situation where they have no choice. But some of them, they always want to do good, but they still fall into sin. But when they fall into sin, they come suddenly and say, I'm sorry. But some people, they are waiting for a chance to commit sin. But since they don't have an opportunity to sin, they keep quiet. Why this? Because they are in the control of the evil one more than the others. Therefore, do not encourage your children to have an attachment to the evil symbols, evil videos, evil games, evil tendencies, evil celebrities, for becoming a fan of evil people. That itself is a dangerous attitude. It is not good for our future, for the future of the child. Everyone should slowly, you have to cultivate a kind of attraction to the goodness. Attraction to the goodness is a sign that you are in the path of salvation. But many people, attraction to the evil, that is a dangerous path.